Welcome back to business studies class. So in last class we have seen the concept of public sector enterprises, isn't it? There we have learnt three types of forms of organization under public sector, that is departmental undertaking, statutory corporation, and then government company. And we have seen related features, merits and demerits, and apart from that examples also we have seen. That is very important to remember because it will be almost compulsory question for 1 or 2 marks. Okay, then you have a next concept called global enterprises. So here you try to understand at this stage, that is at your stage first year, you try to remember that we refer global enterprises or multinational companies or multinational corporations with the same meaning at this stage, but actually they differ, they are not synonymous, okay, they are not same, but at this point we cannot differentiate as per your concept. At this stage we understand, we use them as an alternative words, that is global enterprises, multinational companies, or it is multinational corporation, but actually they are not same. But you will, when you understand in depth the topics, generally we are able to differentiate the three. So at this point you just try to understand, when I refer global enterprise, when I refer multinational company, when I say just MNC or multinational corporation, I'm referring the same things. This you have to remember throughout this particular concept. Okay, when you get into higher classes, when we go into the deep concept of this, all the three, you will surely find the difference between all the three. But in general, in uses also, they are used as alternative words, but actually they are not same. This you remember. Now we'll start with the meaning of knowing what is this global enterprise or MNC. As you can see here, global enterprises, those are huge industrial organizations which extend their industrial and marketing operations through a network of their branches in several countries. Their branches are also called majority owned foreign affiliates, MOFA. This you remember, full form might be asked, MOFA, you please write down that. And please underline that. So when I say global enterprise or multinational companies, MNCs, what does it mean is a particular organization, it might be industry or commerce, a business, when it is expanded to the different countries, okay, both having its industry, that is production unit, and also marketing operations. Okay, see, some businesses may carry on only industry, they don't involve in marketing activity, that is your commerce activities, that is wholesale or retail trade, they may not interfere in any of the things, they just produce and sell. There will be other people who purchase and they go with the commerce activities, that will be different. Okay, so when you see a particular business which is expanded to the different countries, both in their industrial operations and also marketing operations, we call such enterprises, such companies as global enterprises, because globe in the sense entire world we say, right? So when a particular business is expanded to the different nations, okay, their marketing and their production activities are expanded in different nations, we call them as global enterprises or multinational companies. So the branches, we call their branches are called as MOFA, major owned foreign affiliates. Okay, so you can see different companies, they are not produced in our country, they don't belong to our country, but also products we are getting, like different products, for example we say Colgate toothpaste we have, that is actually not from India, that is not an Indian product, somewhere it is produced and it is given to the country. And later on what happened, they have established their industry in India, the owners are not Indians. Okay, so we say it is a foreign product, means it is a product from the different country, but also they are having their industry and they have market, that is they are selling their product in our country, we call it as a global enterprise. Is it clear? Similarly, you can see Samsung mobile sets, you can see it is not from India. Okay, that product is not from India, but also they have industry in our country, they will be selling the products to our country people. So we say such industries are global enterprises, means they are not actually from that particular country, they are from different country, but also they are able to establish their industry and they can sell their products in that particular country. Similarly, if you see Reliance, Infosys, they are in the software, okay, even network, okay, they are Indian companies, but also they have branches in some other countries. They have their industries at different countries and marketing. Our products will be marketed into the different countries. So we say those are MNCs, global enterprises. They are actually Indian companies. Apart from India, they also have their sales, they have industries in some other country. We call them as global enterprises or multinational companies. So the branches, what we call them is MOFA, you have to remember. You can see here, the term global company and multinational company may seem like the same thing, but they have very different features. As I said, when we go into depth of the concept, you find the differences. However, people use global company and multinational company interchangeably, alternative words like they use. So much that people often assume these are the synonymous. Okay. To further to add to the confusion, academics sometimes disagree on the exact definitions of global and multinational company. See, even in academics, that is theoretically, when we study, we may not go in depth like they are different. That is the reason I said at this stage you try to understand both are same. When you get into higher classes, then you will find the difference between the things. The features of MNC, that is global enterprises, are like this: huge capital resources, foreign collaboration, advanced technology, product innovation, marketing strategies, expansion of market territory, and centralized control. See, you can understand here the features when we see, they are somewhat different from the features what we have studied till now. We have seen the features of different forms of organization in private sector, and also we have learned the features, merits and demerits of some of our public sector enterprises. But what you see, the features of MNC are somewhat different. Okay, you can see the first point as huge capital resources. Always try to remember that the MNC's capital will be too high. It will be having vast resources. It might be only, not speaking about only money, that is about capital in form of money, even manpower, technology, in different ways it will be your global enterprise will be equipped with huge resources. Why? Because it will be doing the business on large scale basis, and it will be collecting money from all over the world. Yes, the shares will be sold. The shares will be sold to the foreign countries also. From there also they start acquiring funds. Because they acquire funds from the different sources, their capital will be more. Right? Hence, when you compare to all other forms of business organization, your global enterprises will be having huge capital resources. Much money, much manpower, much technology will be with the MNC. Right? Then foreign collaboration. Generally, MNCs will enter into foreign collaboration. Here, you have to remember, you have different words like collaboration, merging. Okay, generally collaborations and merging, we treat them differently. See, whenever the MNCs enter, see, a particular Indian company, when they want to enter into some foreign country, they want to start their business in the foreign country, they start finding people there. Like they want to get in contact, that they want to get support from some existing industry there. And they start collaborating, they start taking the help, joining their hands with the existing industry in that particular country where they want to start. For example, India want to do business in America. Okay, India want to start a particular industry in America. A particular person, a particular industry already which is existing in India, they want to extend their business in the foreign country, that like USA. Then what these people will do is they'll find a particular industry in USA with them. They'll join the hands initially and they start doing the business. It helps the present country, new company, to flourish like anything in that new country. That is what we say foreign collaboration. They join hands with the different people from the different nations so that they can move with the new country. Because new country market condition, new country's situation, all things will not be known to the different country people, different country industrialists. Hence what happens, Indian company, when they want to start their company in the USA, they'll take the help of some of the existing company in that particular USA, because they are the existing people there, they are the industrialist of that country. They can have more information about their country, and that will be passed to the Indian country. So they join hands to hand and they move into the business. That is what foreign collaboration, that can be possible in your MNC. So it helps the company to flourish like anything in new country also. And even advanced technology they will be having. Generally, these global enterprises are equipped with advanced technology because they have more huge resources, financial resources. With that financial resources, they are accessible to the advanced new technology. You can see, whenever some new technology introduces in the world, these MNCs will take that by paying money. But other industries cannot buy that because of lack of money. You can, best example what we can say is, you might be knowing one of the public sector enterprises, BSNL. So this BSNL could not change or could not adapt to the new technology. Now everyone, we are going with 4G and they are also advancing towards 5G, okay? But this BSNL is unable to give that 4G networks, okay? Because of what? Because of lack of finance. They need more equipments, more technology, but the government is unable to produce. But provide finance to the BSNL. But when you see the other networks like Airtel, Idea, that is V-Mobile, V-Networks, they'll take the technology so fastly because they have financial resources. So whenever the new technology enters into the world, these people, these MNC people will grab that by paying more and more money. The people who don't have such a financial resources cannot go with this technology, hence they cannot give competition to the MNCs. And next one is product innovation. You can observe these MNCs will always goes with product innovation. Means always they want to come out with something new. The same product but something they want to add. You can see advertisements. Many advertisements they'll get refreshed advertisement. Means new advertisement within 3 months or 4 months gap, new advertisement will take place because they'll say something new thing. New thing is added to the product which will be very useful to the consumers. In that way, always they go for the research and they try to come out with the new thing and they try to add to the existing product or they come out with the new product. Because they have finance, technology, because of that what happens, always they will be concentrating on something, innovations. Is it clear? So what happens, people attract, it will attract people. Hence we say MNCs will attract more people. If you don't have more money, you cannot go for research. If you don't go for research, you know, innovations will take place. But because MNCs are having huge resources, advanced technology, they always go for research and they'll come out with one or the other new thing and that they will add to the existing product or they may come out with the new product. In that way, they grab the markets. Then marketing strategies. See, the marketing strategies of MNC will be very aggressive, we say. Aggressive in the sense, very strange, very horrible strategies they will be. Strategies are nothing but plans which are developed to face your enemy. Is it clear? So strategy is a type of plan developed, made in order to face the competitor, enemy. Okay, so these MNCs will develop such a marketing strategies, such marketing plans to defeat its competitors. For example, if there is a competition between MNC and one of the industry, the industry is not an MNC, it is just doing its business in a particular country, that's it. There is some other company which is MNC, which is working in different countries. So the strategies, the marketing strategy, marketing in the sense, once the goods produced, how it has to be sold in the market. That is what marketing activities we say. Okay, in order to sell the product in the market, the MNCs will be having aggressive strategies. In the sense, they can come out with vast discounts, they can come out with more gifts, they can come out with such a plans which attracts more and more customers. Because as they are doing business in different countries, the business, if it places loss from one country, that can be recouped from the profits made from some other country. See, for example, in India to sell a particular product, there is high competition. But in some other country like China, there may not be any competition. So what happens, where there is no competition, there they will be selling the product for higher prices. Where they are having high competition, there they will be reducing the prices like anything to attract the consumers. So in India, they may face some loss, but also they are making good profit in some other country. So that profit can be recouped to the company. Because they have such a facility, they have aggressive strategies. Means aggressive in the sense, their discounts, their offers are mind blowing like anything. The general company cannot give such discounts, such cannot give such offers. If they give such offers, they will be in loss. But MNC can do that because as they have their marketing and industries at the different countries, one if they face loss at one point, they can recoup from other profit, from the profit what they get from the other country. Because of such facilities, they have aggressive marketing strategies, the MNCs. Then expansion of market territory. Market territory in the sense the area what they expand for selling their goods. Generally, more very fastly there will be expansion of market territory. See, initially they enter as exporters. See, they produce the goods in their country, they start exporting. For example, China, you can see. China is a big market, we say. So for them, India is a big market, to be frank. Means their product will be sold like anything in India. Okay, once they have occupied India, they target on some other country. They target on like Pakistan also, they target. They target on USA. They target on Japan. Like this, they target on the countries to expand their business. That is what, and so fastly can they do because they can reduce the prices like anything. They have advanced technology. They have huge resources. Because of all these resources, they can expand their market like anything to the different countries. That can be possible through your MNC. And we have centralized control. As I said, there will be different branches called MOFA, but it will be controlled by the head office. For example, the industry is basic from USA, the head office will be in USA, but it will be having branches in different countries where they are doing industrial and marketing activities. But it will be controlled by whom? The head office, which is located in USA. It is like that. For example, a particular product is from Japan and the market, they have industry and they are selling the product at the different countries. So all those countries branches will be controlled by the Japan head branch. Is it clear? So every policy according to that circumstances will be released by whom? The head office. That is what centralized control we say. Though they are working in different countries, they are controlled by the particular head office. That is what we say, centralized control. So these are the features of MNC. Kindly go with your notes and textbook. There you will be having good information about that. Okay, so this can be asked for 4 marks, and if you are able to write at least 4, 1 point extra, like 5 points if you are able to write, and at least 3 lines of explanation for each, that will be very helpful. Okay, till we meet in our next class, take care.